Good morning, friends. A professor in National Law University on the topic of victimology and criminology has written an article in the Hindu, which attracted the attention of so many people, and therefore I am making a video on this topic. This is unlocking justice from lockdown. That means justice is also locked. So we have to unlock the justice from this lockdown period. So to sum up, the first point he raised is that the legal practice, and that means the court and the advocates, they should be computed in the essential services category, permitted activities category. So this is the actually his suggestion. Otherwise, the fundamental rights cannot be realized, right? So we all know that the COVID-19 pandemic, it has compelled the state, for that matter, the entire world, to suspend the work, the movement, the business, the services, and liberty of the people and more. It has almost, they came to a standstill. But the constitution should not be suspended. The liberties should not be suspended. But now the operation of the constitution, it is in limbo as almost complete shutdown of India's judicial system is there practically. Right? What is happening is, of course, there are so many occasions where there is a necessity for the justice or for the operation of the legal practice because the enforcement of the constitutional rights like health, life and liberty and food also they require urgent resolution, because even though the government is taking all measures, the migrant laborers, they are stranded on the roads literally. They do not have any shelter to live and there is no food for them. Leave alone the health facility. Where is the SF health facility? Actually, in Hindu, it has come that 96% of the laborers or the migrant laborers, they are not getting their salaries, leave only their wages and food. Therefore, such is the situation. So then the lawyers should have unfettered access to the courts for raising the voice. No doubt, there are so many advocates filing public interest litigations, mostly in the sub court, occasionally in the high courts they are doing. But local courts, they are not able to function. So please remember, due to the non-inclusion of the advocates and lawyers and also the courts in the permitted activities, definitely it is denying access to liberty of the people, denying the fundamental rights to the people. Interestingly or curiously, judiciary, the judicial system also, it has retreated to the background. Literally, of course, the High Court and Supreme Court, they are taking up only the important cases, that too through the video conferencing. Whereas the lower courts, they are restricted to taking up the remand cases and not all the other cases, simply they are adjourning matter. Right? So now it is giving a space for the executive. It is a yes. Now they are taking up the law into their own hands. The legal and constitutional matters, now they are being taken up by the executive. No doubt. People are saying, of course, it is the opinion of the judges also, since they are conducting the virtual conference or video conferencing trial. No doubt, it will be good to some extent, but if the internet doesn't work, if the person is not tech savvy, and if the mobile or the instrument does not work properly, what happens? Even though they give a link, it's not possible for the video conferencing. Moreover, the client will not be able to have access. It is not open. So the persons who are giving the link, even the advocates, if their term is over, they will be disconnected from the link and they do not know what is happening to the other cases. So this is the problem. So therefore, that way, very recently the Bar Council of India has also written a letter to the Supreme Court requesting to take up the formal or normal hearings after the lockdown, because most of the advocates, some of the advocates I can say, they are not actually habituated to this video conferencing through Zoom app or through WhatsApp, all these things. Most of them do not know. You can't expect all the people, all the advocates to know the facts of this so-called video conferencing. Right? One. Second point, the police, no doubt, they are more concentrating on the pandemic. They are doing all their best. At the same time, they have to do the investigation duty. They are taking up, say, whenever they find time, they are taking up the old cases also. They are effecting the arrest of people. Very recently, in Guwahati, on 7/4/2020, two activists were arrested in a PD, a public distribution system of rice, which happened in the year 2018. And when the press made a hullabaloo stating that the government authorities and the politicians, they are siphoning off the rice intended for the PD's public distribution system. Now they arrested the two people. They cannot approach the lawyers. And another incident I'll tell you. Citizenship Amendment Act, so it has created, so December 2019, and it has created ruckus, and even the universities have to be closed. And in this case, which happened in the year December 2019, the Delhi police arrested two students, university students, under the Unlawful Activities Prevention Act. Then so you may be knowing, Article 22 says that the arrested person and the detained person can be defended by a lawyer of his chance. But where is the chance for procuring a lawyer? How can the lawyer go there? So he has to take a pass. By the time he takes a pass, it will be one day, and by the time they will be remanded to judicial custody. Thus, the legal protection has vanished in this period of lockdown. And now, third point. Now, the police, they are taking up the summary punishment. Since the legal authorities are not there, since the courts are not functioning properly, the police, summary punishments by the police without any sanction of law, they are pouring in from across the country. Already, I have done a video on this topic also. So, you know, even in the so-called Muslim country, Saudi Arabia, flogging is prohibited till now at this juncture. But still, the police, the videos of police force, so making persons perform the push-ups and squatting on the roads, and also vandalizing the vegetable carts, throwing away the vegetable carts, and harassing the migrant laborers and homeless people, they are definitely, videos are coming up, and they are evidence of arbitrariness on the part of the police. Even knowing, very recently, the Director General of Police of Telangana State, he stated that the vehicles of the people who come unnecessarily on the roads, they will be seized and kept in the some places, and they will be sent to the court after this lockdown period is over, and then only they can get back their vehicles. Of course, his intention, I cannot attribute any malintention to the DCP level officer, but the way in which he is spoken, of course, it is to threaten the people, it's a different issue. But still, what happens? Suppose, why the fellow comes onto the roads normally to get some vegetables or to some milk, bread or medicines, things like that. Normal, for that purpose only they to come. Of course, there are a few people who do not have any work and come. You cannot differentiate them, because you have been seeing a lot of vehicles being flooded in the DRM school grounds in Ongole, in so many places, in parade grounds, they are dumping them. But whatever the security is a different aspect. Anyway, the police officer said that they will send them to court after the lockdown period. We don't know when it will end. Even let us say it will end by May 7th. Then they have to send them to the court. So once again, they have to file a petition under 457 or 451 of the CRPC to get them back. How difficult it is. After all, what is the crime they committed? They came on the road. So for this, a laborious process, because the courts are not there. If the courts were here already, the Supreme Court, the High Court of Kerala, took a sumoto petition and stated that the vehicles should be released after the payment of some money from the owners, like 1,000, like that. So these are the difficulties when the legal provisions are not there, or when the justice is becoming inaccessible. So with this, the public are definitely, they are becoming powerless. Nowadays another issue has come. The National Commission for Women, they are saying that the incidents of domestic violence for the 40 days since wife and husband are there, domestic violence, they are being on the rise, and therefore the governments have to give a number to check up the so-called domestic violence. So they are on the increase. If there is a court, definitely the woman can touch the court and she can get a protection order. When the court is not functioning, what is that she can do? Now let us go to other countries. What are the systems in other countries? In UK, United Kingdom, the legal practitioners, they declare them as essential services, and they think that they are the key workers. Of course, they have notified how different category of courts shall function. On one day, one particular court, second day, second particular court, third day, social distancing, all these things, they have given clear directions. As far as USA is concerned, yes, they declared that the workers supporting the Homeland Security operations, that is police, Homeland Security is nothing but police and also court. So they are essential services. So the advocates, the staff, the court staff, they can go and they can perform their functions. Of course, in a limited, our country is different anyway. So anyway, the suggestion from this professor is that India should adopt minimum judicial infrastructure. This is most important, please, here. That's why I'm reading. So minimum judicial infrastructure and the manner of taking up the priority cases and list of the key personnel. So who have to move from court to court and from house to house and move from the court to the prison and all these things. So they have to summarize the duties. They have to mention the same, and definitely the courts will start functioning. So normally people are of the impression that there is no court literally function, even though the High Court state is virtual functioning or video conference, and the lower courts, they are taking up only remand matters and adjourning all these cases. Of course, if the lockdown ends by this May 3rd, it's okay. Otherwise, definitely people will not be able to access the justice immediately. So therefore, the lacunae was what suggested by them. They should be, of course, they should be remedied, and justice should not become a casualty during this pandemic season. Therefore, he is giving advice to the government at least to see that some courts do function and take up the priority matters, and also some lawyers to be allowed to the court by following the so-called social distance measures, whatever they want to take. But there should be some system. But the system should not retreat, and people should not think that there is no court, there is no justice, they cannot approach the lawyers. This is basically so the recommendations of the professor. So unlocking justice in the lockdown, it has been published in Hindu. If you find time, please read it and enrich your knowledge. Thank you very much.